Hello everyone, welcome back. Today we are going to study the EVS lesson of 4th grade, the animal kingdom. Okay, in this lesson we will study about the identification of similarities and differences between human beings and animals. And also we will understand the relationship between human beings and animals. So let's begin. In the previous lessons, we have already studied about animals. We know that birds and insects are also the animals, and we human beings belong to the group of animals. Okay, here one activity is there. Observe the animals that you see around you and identify the similarities that find between animals and yourself. So, what is the common thing which we find between we and the animals? We should write here. Okay. So, shall we write animals and we move from one place to another place, right? Okay. Next, animals and we need food to live, right? Yes. Animals and we give birth to the young ones, correct? So, like this, some of the similarities are there between animals and ourselves, okay? Here, look at these pictures, look at the pictures and observe the difference between you and a cow. Okay, so what are the differences between we and cow? Here we will write the differences between, okay, in the I column we will write, I have 2 legs, cow have 4 legs, okay. I don't have tail, cow have tail. Okay, I wear clothes, cow do not wear clothes. Okay, another one we will write. Cow gives milk, I don't give milk. So, these are the differences between I and cow. Okay. Here one column is there, in that some of the names of the animals are there. We have to write the size, color, food and dwelling. Dwelling means the place where they live, okay, of the following animals. So cow, what is the size of the cow? We can write big. Color, whichever color you have saw, you can write white, brown, black. Food, cow eat grass. Dwelling, the place where cow lives, it is shed. Fish, size of the fish, whichever type of fish you have seen, you can write that. You can write small. Color of the fish, whichever color you have saw, you can write. Food of the fish, insects. Where do the fish live? Water. Crane, size of the crane, small. Color of the crane, white. Food of the crane, insects, fish. Place where crane live, pond. Next, butterfly. Size of the butterfly, small. Color of the butterfly, you can write whichever color you have saw, you can write the color of that. Food of the butterfly, leaves, you can write. Insects also you can write. And dwelling where the butterfly lives, the place of the butterfly where it lives, you can write. Monkey, size of the monkey, small. Color of the monkey, brown. Food of the monkey, fruits and vegetables. And also you can write insects also, because monkey is an omnivorous, right, that eats both herbs and flesh. Okay, where does the monkey lives? In forest. Like that you can write for garden lizard, rabbit, grasshopper, tortoise and bats. Sizes of these animals, color of these animals, what do these animals eat and where do these animals live. Okay. Now fill in the blanks. A few animals like fish live in dash. Fish lives in water. So here you can write water. Monkeys, birds and insects live on dash. It lives on tree. You can write here tree. Many animals like dash and dash live on land. Here you have to write the examples of two animals which live on land. Shall we write lion and elephant? Okay, lion, elephant, cow, deer, whichever animals that lives on land, you can write the names of them. Okay, let us move to the next. Okay, here. Different animals eat different kinds of food, right? Based on the animals eat their food, the animals are classified into three groups. This one we have already studied in the third standard. So here, let us fill in the blanks by different animals eat different kinds of food. Okay, animals which eat the product of plants such as grass, leaf, etc. are called dash. Animals which eat herbs, they are called herbivorous animals. Okay, animals which eat flesh, egg and other product of animals are called carnivorous animal. Animals which eat product of both plants and animals are called omnivorous animals. So this one you have already studied in third standard, right? Based on the food the animals eat, they are classified into three groups: herbivorous, carnivorous and omnivorous. Okay, next, observe the size of animals you see around you. We see different types of animals around us, right? So we need to observe the different types of animals and birds which we see around us. Next question, from which animal is the milk used in your house got from? The milk which we use in our home will get from the cow and buffalo. So we have to write here cow, buffalo. Make a list of the food items used in your house. Draw a circle around the food items obtained from the animals. First, let us write what are the food items we get in our house. So let us write fruits, vegetables, meat, cereals, pulses, fish, spices, egg, ragi, rice. Okay, so these are all the animals food items, sorry, these are all the food items which we use in our house. Now let us put circle for the animals obtained from the animal, for the food obtained from the animals. Okay, we will put round mark for the meat. We get meat from the animals. We get egg from hen, so egg. Fish, we get fish also from animals. Okay, now write five uses of animals. Let us write five uses of animals. First, let us write hen gives us egg, dog guards our house, fish gives us meat, sheep gives us wool and meat, and last, cow gives us milk. Like this, we can write whichever uses of animals you want to write, you can write here. Okay, next. See here, the pictures which are given here shows how animals are useful to us. So let us write the uses of the animals in the space provided in the pictures. Okay, first, what can you see? You can see here eagle eating the dead worms. Okay, so let us write eagle, let us write birds. Okay, birds eat the worms and keeps the environment clean. Okay, honeybee, honeybee gives us honey. Ox helps in plowing the field. Horse, horse are used in horse carriage. Fishes, fishes eat insects in water and keeps the water clean. Okay, cow, cow gives us milk. Sheep, sheep gives us wool. Dog, dog guards our house. So these are the different types of uses of animals. Next, do you rear animals in your house? How do you look after them? Rearing of animals, this lesson you have already studied in your previous classes, in your third standard, right? So what is the meaning of rearing of animals? Rearing of animals means taking care of animals in the house. So do you have any animal in your house which you take care? If you have yes, write yes. If you have no, you write no. In my home, I don't rear any animals, so I will write no, I don't rear animals in my house. Okay, now let us help this boy to reach the home without getting caught by the dog. Okay, so here I will start helping the boy to go to the home without getting caught by dogs. So is this the right way? Am I drawing? Am I helping the boy to reach the home? Yes, okay, let us move. Fine. So like this way we have helped this boy to reach the home. Okay, next. Match the following animals and their uses. Here let us match. Ox helps in plowing. Buffalo gives us milk. Sheep gives us wool. Hen gives us egg. Horse carriage, jhatka. Fish eating insects in water and keeping the water clean. Eagle eating dead animals and keeping the environment clean. Okay, next. Who I am, riddles are there, very nice and interesting thing. So let us solve these riddles. I have colorful feathers. I am the village clock. Okay, which bird is having the colorful feathers and which bird helps the village to get up early in the morning? Village clock. Cock, C-O-C-K, cock. I am big with a large belly. I have tails both at the front and at the back. Answer for this is seahorse. Seahorse is having a large belly and a tail at the front and the back. Next question. I have a very small, smart body, long ears and small whiskers. I hop swiftly. Which animal hops swiftly? Rabbit. Yes. So we will write rabbit. I climb the top of the tree where no one can climb. I eat fruits. Which animal climbs the top of the tree and eat fruits? Monkey. Yes. So we will write monkey. I am the aunt of the tiger. I eat rats. Which animal is the aunt of the tiger and eat rats? Cat. Yes. So this is all about the riddles. Here some facts are there. Do you know these facts? The tiger is the national animal of India. Nowadays the number of tigers are decreasing. The Project Tiger, a project of the government of India, is to preserve tigers. Okay, to save the tigers, the government have launched the project tiger, because tiger is the national animal of our country. Okay, next fact. The number of insects is very large in the animal kingdom. In the whole animals, insects are having large numbers in this world. Cheetah runs at 100 km per hour. Cheetah is the fastest running animal and it runs at 100 km per hour. The blue whale, which is 33 meter long, is the biggest animal in the animal kingdom. So, which is the biggest animal in the animal kingdom? The blue whale. Some animals like chameleon and leaf insects change their color to suit their environment to protect themselves from enemies. So, chameleon and the leaf insects are the animals which change their color to protect themselves from the enemies. So this is all about the lesson number 1, the animal kingdom of EVS grade 4. If you want more lessons, please check out in my channel. And if you like this video, if this video are helpful for you, if you want more lessons like this, please subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching.